When I first saw my first optical genome mapping, I was just astounded at not just the level of detail, the level of structural variants that were found, but the actual granularity.
The lab is very excited to use this technology and then identify something which is traditionally being missed by our standard of care or traditional methods.
Not only giving a better definition of the prognostic category that they're in, but potentially uncovering new therapeutic markers.
Specifically, we can, in a very easy way, now access regions of the genomes that were almost inaccessible with other means. That clearly already shows the power of OGM. In 2019, my former colleague contacted me and explained to me what happened in this family. Two daughters suffered from an extremely rare disease called ATRT, which stands for atypical teratoid rhabdoid tumors. Very distinct tumors of the nervous system, particularly of a certain brain area. The first child, under treatment, still lived for 2 years, however, then passed away due to the severity of that disease. And then in the second pregnancy, the second daughter was also diagnosed with the same condition, but her tumor already metastasized and was untreatable, so she passed away a few weeks after birth. It was clear it must be a genetic disease, but we couldn't identify the mutation. So for the family, there was no other option than not conceiving children at that stage, not considering it until they would have an answer. So the pressure was on us to finally identify the disease-causing mutation and the mutation that predisposes to this childhood cancer.
Onze dochter Roos is hier in het Radboud geboren en daar meteen door de scan gegaan. En op die scan werd een hersentumor zichtbaar. Een biopt heeft toen uitgewezen dat er sprake was van een ATRT-tumor. Middels bloedonderzoek gekeken naar die genetische factor, heeft zij toen vastgesteld dat er in het bloed of in de bloedcellen geen afwijking te zien was. Toen onze tweede dochter met exact dezelfde tumor werd geboren, kwam ze opnieuw bij ons in beeld. Omdat eigenlijk toen iedereen wel de verwachting had van ja, dit kan geen toeval meer zijn, dit moet genetisch zijn.
That stage, there was strong evidence that there must be a predisposing germline mutation in the SMARCB1 gene. However, diagnostic assays such as Sanger sequencing, MLPA, CNV microarray, and ultimately also exome sequencing failed to identify the disease-causing mutation. Then my collaborators and colleagues from Utrecht also considered short-read genome sequencing. And again, they were unable to identify the disease-causing mutation. And that is exactly the stage where they contacted us. We just purchased the first OGM instrument and set up OGM as a technology here in-house. So we were able to perform OGM and immediately filtered for rare structure variant. We usually are left with just 30 to 50 rare variants genome-wide. But strikingly, one of those events happened to be in the so strongly suspected SMARCB1 locus. Obviously, there was a big relief that we finally identified the mutation. And then also a prenatal assay by my colleagues at Diagnostics was designed to soon after offer the family a prenatal test that can, with 100% certainty, show whether any subsequent pregnancy would carry the mutation or not.
Ja, dat was bijna onbeschrijfelijk. Omdat je bij alle voorgaande testen daar niets uitkwam. En ineens hebben ze iets.
Na jarenlange teleurstelling, weer een sprankje hoop wat er ineens is. Je wil heel graag begrijpen hoe dit heeft kunnen gebeuren. Om te kunnen snappen van wat is er nou misgegaan.
Onzekerheid is een verschrikkelijk iets. En dat werd weggenomen. Was voor ons echt heel prettig.
They learned that the mutation is not present. So the next baby would not have the same condition that the two sisters passed away from. A big relief, that was a big moment for that family, but certainly also for us. They were able to conceive another baby, and luckily that baby is a very healthy baby boy.
We weten gewoon dat hij gezond is en dat hij groeit en bloeit en ontwikkelt zich. En het is een prachtig kind. En
lijkt op zijn zussen.
Ja, dat, ja. Ja, onbeschrijfelijk. Wat een geluk, hè? En dat ons dit nog gegeven is.
Nooit durven dromen dat het nog zou mogen gebeuren. Ja.